Good morning, everyone. Now, I am going to teach friction. So, before solving the numericals and friction topic, I have given some introduction about what is meant by friction, and I have given some examples like how it has been produced, and also we can see some basic introductions in this topic. So, definition of friction. Friction is the resistance offered to the movement of the body. So here I have given some three examples. Like in the first example, a man is been walking and he is been like pushing one block. That man is having some weight and he is like pushing a weight of 32 kgs. And you can see the position of hand, which is 21 degrees inclined, and there is a force produced by this man. So he can able to walk only because of friction. The same you can see in the second figure as well as in the third figure. So you can see a vehicle which is being loaded with some three blocks. This is because like rolling friction. Rolling friction is happening in this tire, and this man has been pushing this object. So again we have some three more examples. Again a man is pushing some weight, and second one is while walking. We can able to walk only because of friction. Only in the hard surface we can able to walk. If the surface is very smooth, we cannot able to walk, because in the smooth surface the friction will always be zero. And even in the tires, a vehicle can be moved only because of friction. You can see some in the tires, you can see how it is being designed in order to run in the road. So we can see the proper definition of the friction. Friction is a force that acts in the opposite direction to the movement. Yes, see, if this is the block, the movement, if it is in one side, the opposite side will be the frictional force. It is produced always in the opposite side of the movement of the body. So a force which always opposes the motion, which it will be in the opposite direction of your motion, and even the object in contact with it. So it is like if a man is walking in the surface, his own weight is traveling in one direction. You can see the same and opposite force, that is called as a friction. So again we can see that friction enables us to walk without slipping. As I said, if you want to walk forward, you can see even how the leg pushes the air in order to move forward, because there is a frictional force between the sole of the shoe and the ground, which prevents us from slipping. This both action only will make us to walk in a certain direction. See, this is a man leg. Even you can consider this as a force. This force is having the motion in one side, whereas the friction is in the opposite side. So we push the ground backward and we go front. We go forward, whereas the friction acts in the opposite direction, and it also prevents us from slipping, and it makes us to balance in one. Like balancing our own weight. So here I have posted few examples of walking, how we are walking, and what are the different forces acts while we are walking, and which makes us to balance our weight as well as walking in one particular path. So friction helps us to walk, as I said. So here you can observe there are few surfaces which is like in the cold or in the snowy surfaces, man is been falling. You can observe that. See, if for example, if you have poured some water or oil in the floor, and if you can able to walk in that, sure there will be no frictional force, and you will seems to be like falling at one particular point. It says that for the smooth surface, the friction will be zero. It happens. See here, even you can see if some oil or water is the floor is under maintenance, it's been clean, and a man is walking under that, he cannot able to balance his own weight, he is falling. And the same is happening in the icy floor also. And friction enables a car to move on a road without skidding. So because of the friction between the tires of the car and the road only, the a vehicle can able to move forward without skidding. If there were no friction, car would like stay where it is. It cannot able to move forward. There is two types of friction. One is like a rolling friction and one is a sliding. Another one is a sliding friction. Rolling friction means one object will be rolling over another object. Sliding means one object slides over the another object. So this rolling friction you can observe in the cars. So where wheel is turning in the road, that is it's pushing the road in another side. That's why it's can able to move in one particular side. And here I have some examples of wheels, how it has been placed and the design of wheels in order to frictional resistance. And we'll see another one more thing. A friction enables a car to move in the road without skidding. Yes, you can able to move without skidding, as I said already. If there is any water or oil split in the surface, means it's very difficult for the tire to move forward. And friction enables us to write and draw in paper, same thing. If we have some resistance for the pen, like for example, if you can able to catch the pen at one particular point, means the if the pen lead, when we are drawing, it is offering some resistance. That's why you can see the black marks on the paper. The tip of the pencil or a pen and the paper itself produces a friction while drawing, and even while writing in the ink pen you can see, and while even using a tab or something which are like with a touch pad, here you can see how the friction is acting. And next is holding or picking up and holding things in our hands. So whatever things we handle, if it has some friction only, you can able to catch hold on it, else it will fall. For that we have some examples like a glass tumbler in our hand, and the friction between the hand and the tumbler. And for example, here is some vessel, even it has so much friction, that's why you can able to the surface is very hard, that's why it produces a good friction and you can handle it. And even the money, you can count only like see how the man is holding. If it is very smooth, you cannot able to even count. And the same is applicable for a glass tumbler and everything. Once if it is very smooth or you cannot able to catch like this. So again we have one more example, that a friction enables us to light the matchstick. For example, we have a matchstick and a matchbox. At one side it will be very rough. If you rub only, you will get the fire in the other side. This is because of the heat. The burning happens only because of friction. The friction between both the sides only produces and makes the head to burn always. So these are the basic introduction about the friction. In the next presentation, I'll be teaching you what is the coefficient of friction, angle of repose, angle of friction, cone of friction, and all basic numericals. Thank you.